Hello, good morning students. This is C.R. Sir, Mathematics faculty. Now today I am going to discuss that in functions, how to find out the domain and range. First I am going to discuss the domain and range definitions. Now first see the domain. For a given function, y is equal to f of x. For a given function, y is equal to f of x. The set of values which x can take, provided that for those values y is well defined, is known as the domain of the function. That means in that function, in place of x, well defined value we can substitute. Well-defined values we want to take. Those values we are saying that domain of the function. We can say another word also. When the function is defined, such values we will say that domain of the given function. Now see the range. For a given function y is equal to f of x, the set of values which y can take corresponding to each real number in the domain is known as range of the function. The range of the function is set of all values of f of x. That means set of values of y is called range of the function. Now, one function given. What is the domain? What is the range? Difference, observe that. The values of which input can take. That meaning is when the function is defined, that values, that means input. Domain means input. Then what is the range? After substituting the input, what we are getting the output? That is called range. The values which output can take, that is range of the function. Okay. Now, domain means input of the function. Range means output. Now I am going to discuss that some problems. Here, first problem, see that what they are given. The domain of f of x is equal to x square minus 2x plus 1 divided by x minus 1 into x minus 2. In this function, there is no roots, there is no logarithms. That means this is, we will say that, algebraic function. For suppose f of x is equal to 1 by g of x. When this function exists, if denominator is not equal to 0 means the function is exist. The function is defined. So in algebraic function, denominator is not equal to 0. Now substitute, now observe here. In this function, what is the denominator? X minus 1 into x minus 2 not equal to 0. So x minus 1 not equal to 0, x minus 2 not equal to 0. So finally, x is not equal to 1 and x is not equal to 2. So in place of x, you are taking 1 and 2 means the function cannot be defined. Except to 1 and 2. In place of x, except 1 and 2, the function is domain. The function is exist, sorry. In place of x, substitute for all real numbers except to 1 and 2. That is the domain of the function. Now finally I am writing domain of f of x. Domain of f of x is for all real numbers except 1, 2. If you are substituted x is equal to 1 and 2, denominator is going to 0. So denominator going to 0 means the function cannot be defined. It can be undefined. Now observe the second problem. Here also there is no roots, there is no logarithms. So finally we will say that this is algebraic function. Whenever is there algebraic function, when it is exist, if it is denominator not equal to 0 means exist. So x cube plus 4x square plus 3x not equal to 0. Take x common. Now remaining is x square plus 4x plus 3 is not equal to 0. This is quadratic equation split into factors. So you will get like this. That is x plus 1 into x plus 3 not equal to 0. Here observe that x is not equal to 0, comma, x plus 1 is not equal to 0. So x is not equal to minus 1. X plus 3 not equal to 0 means x is not equal to minus 3. So the function is defined for all real numbers except 0, minus 1, 3. So now we can write domain of f of x is for all real numbers except 0, minus 1, minus 3. Okay. Now observe the third question. F of x is equal to 1 by mod x minus x. This is also algebraic function only. When the function is defined, if denominator not equal to 0 means it is defined. So mod x is not equal to x. So when it is possible, whenever we are taking negative value, both sides is not exist. For suppose, verify that. If take x is equal to 0, mod 0 how much? 0, not equal to 0. This condition is false. So x is equal to 0 is not exist. Take that x is equal to 1, what happened? Mod 1, 1, not equal to 1. This is also false. Take x is equal to minus 1, mod of minus 1, that is 1, not equal to minus 1. Yes, this condition is exist. So finally what I am saying means the domain of the function in place of x, you are taken less than 0 means, that means negative values. So the domain of the function is x is less than 0, or we can write another way also, that is minus infinite comma 0 open bracket. This is the domain of the function f of x is equal to 1 by mod x minus x. Next, this is fourth question. Here observe that roots are there. Then how to do that? How to find out the root? So we know that general method f of x is equal to under root g of x. Inside the root function, when it is exist first, when it is exist, if g of x is greater than or equal to 0, root is not exist for negative values. It is exist for 0 and positive. For suppose f of x is equal to 1 by under root g of x given. Already we know that root is not exist for negative values. It is exist for 0 and positive. In case, in place of g of x, you are taken 0 means 1 by root 0. It is going to undefined. Whenever is a root in the denominator, then it is exist. G of x is greater than 0. So remember it, these two conditions. If root is there in the numerator, the condition is greater than or equal to 0. Root is there in the denominator means just only greater than 0. Now observe the fourth question. Root is there in the numerator. When the function is defined, x minus 1, x minus 2, x minus 3, greater than or equal to 0 means the function is defined. Now, by observing Wavy curve method, see here, this is a number line. Draw the numbers, x minus 1, that is x is equal to 1, here is the 1, x minus 2, x is equal to 2, x minus 3, x is equal to 3. This is infinite, this is minus infinite. So we know that wavy curve method. So observe the right hand side onwards. First this term is positive, next negative, positive, negative. Here greater than or equal to 0 means 0 and positive. So where it is positive? In between 1 and 2 and 3 to infinite. Here is positive. So how to write the domain of the function? So that is x belongs to. So here equality symbol is there. That means 1 and 2 both are included. Union. Closed. 3 comma infinite. Here in place of infinite, always write open bracket because that is not exact value, that is large number. Finally, the domain of f of x is what? Closed interval 1 comma 2 union 3 comma infinite. Okay, now I am going to fifth problem. This is observe that f of x is equal to under root 4 minus x square. Root is there in the numerator. So what is the condition? The function is defined when 4 minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. Write the reverse. We get x square minus 4 means I am writing 2 square is less than or equal to 0. So this is in the form of a square plus b square. How to write? X plus 2 into x minus 2 less than or equal to 0. Here draw that number line. Draw the number line. What are the numbers here? One is minus 2. Another one is 2. This is infinite. This is minus infinite. We know that wavy curve method. So starts with positive. This is positive. This is negative. This is positive. Here we got x plus 2 into x minus 2 less than or equal to 0. That means these values we want to take. Therefore, the domain of the function. Domain means x values only. X belongs to closed. Minus 2 comma 2. Why I am writing close? Here equality symbol is there. So minus 2 and 2 both are included. Finally, domain of the function f of x is equal to under root 4 minus x square is closed minus 2 comma 2. Now go to the another question. This is sixth question. F of x is equal to x by under root x square minus 3x plus 2. Here observe that root is there in the denominator. Already we have discussed here conditions. Root is there in the denominator means what is the condition? Greater than 0. So here when the function is defined means x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than 0 means the function is defined. So this is quadratic equation. Split into factors. Finally, you will get x minus 1 into x minus 2 greater than 0. After splitting the factors, we get like this. Draw the number line. Number line. This is infinite. This is minus infinite. X minus 1, 0 means x is equal to 1. This is x is equal to 2. Now, wavy curve method, we know that starts with positive, negative, positive. But here observe that x minus 1 into x minus 2 greater than 0. What we have to take? These values. Wherever is there positive values, those we want to take. Now, finally, the domain of the function is x belongs to open interval minus infinite comma 1 open union 2 comma infinite. Why we are writing union? The combined solution I am writing. Okay. So finally, the domain of the function is minus infinite comma 1 union open interval 2 comma infinite. So this is, we can write another way also. So that is x less than 1 or x greater than 2. This is also correct. X less than 1 means less than 1, minus infinite to 1. Greater than 2 means 2 to infinite. Next, observe the 7th question. The domain of the function 2x plus 3 by x minus 2 into 3 minus x. This is a problem. Here, when the function is defined, the denominator inside the root value is just greater than 0 means the function is defined. It is greater than 0. Here, see that 3 minus x is there. Take the minus common, minus of x minus 2 into 3 minus x means I am taking minus common, we get x minus 3 greater than 0. So minus in right hand side, the symbol is going to change. X minus 2, x minus 3 less than 0. Okay, now take the number line. What are the values? One is 2, another one is 3. Here is the infinite, this is minus infinite. Now, wavy curve method, we know that. First positive, negative, positive. Less than 0 means that is negative. These values we want to take. Those values are domain. Therefore, domain of the function, that is x belongs to open interval 2 comma 3. Or we can write another way. 2 less than x less than 3. In between 2 and 3, whatever is their values, all values are defined by the function. Okay, so finally we will say that domain of the function is open interval 2 comma 3. That's the last question. This is the 8th one. What they are given? F of x function. Here root is a complete numerator and denominator. So when the function is defined inside the root, always greater than or equal to 0 means it will be defined. Now, how to do this? Numerator and denominator, I am going to multiply with x minus 7 divided by x minus 7 whole square, because already one term is greater than or equal to 0. Denominator part square is there. That means it is always positive. Then what about numerator? Numerator also positive. 2 minus x, x minus 7, it is greater than 0. Greater than or equal to 0 we can take. But x minus 7 is not equal to 0. If x minus 7 0 means anything by 0, undefined. So x is not equal to 7. Here take minus common. We get minus of x minus 2 into x minus 7 greater than or equal to 0. Minus and right hand side, what we get? X minus 2 into x minus 7 less than or equal to 0. Now draw the number line. This is 2. This is 7, this is infinite, this is minus infinite. By observing wavy curve method, first positive, negative, positive. So less than or equal to 0 means it is negative only. So how to write the domain of the function? X belongs to close 2, 7 and x is not equal to 7. So closed bracket means the numbers are included. So 7 we want to exclude. Finally, domain of the function x belongs to closed 2, 7 open interval. This is we can write another way also. That is 2 less than or equal to x less than 7. This is domain of the function. This is domain of the function. Now, overall observe that we have discussed 8 problems. These are very, very important problems. I think, I hope all of you understood now. If still now you are not subscribed my channel, please subscribe the channel and click the like button and share to your friends. I will make more videos. Okay. Thank you.